What is Manifest Destiny?
Manifest Destiny is a ideology that was in the 1840s and 50s in the United States, that America had a God-given right to take over the rest of the continent and sort of spread its values and its virtues from sea to shining sea.
Right, so it's God's plan.
That was the idea, yes.
Doesn't this make you God's slaves?
Well, I think what the people of the time would say is that they were God's missionaries on Earth, and so they felt that they were willingly enacting his policies rather than being forced to do so.
But at the very least, you're God's bitches. In the Cuban Missile Crisis, which was more dangerous, the cubes or the missiles?
You're thinking of the Cuban Missile Crisis, which refers to Cuba, which is a country off the coast of the United States near Florida.
Isn't a cube a terrible shape for a missile? It'd be more like a brick. The Civil War tore America apart, didn't it? Brother turned on brother. Did anyone get so conflicted they turned on themselves?
I don't think so. There may have been some very strong debates within individuals of which side to join. And I think that could be what you're perhaps referencing.
How come people say it was the first modern war when you can see from the photos it was ages ago?
Well, it's interesting you reference the photos because it's the first war that photography really played a part. It was something where photographs were part of the conflict and documenting the violence.
Must have been quite exciting going to Snappy Snaps afterwards and seeing which ones had turned out and which ones hadn't. The Cold War is quite complicated, isn't it? Should we definitely bother mentioning it in this, or could we just give it a miss?
It defines most of the second half of the 20th century, so I think you should probably include it.
Oh, right, okay. Who was Abraham Lincoln, and why did he have all those weird tattoos on his tummy?
I have no idea what you're referring to with the tattoos, but he is a US president, revered as probably the best US president.
Apparently he had like a snowman and a robin tattooed on his tummy, and the robin had a mustache.
I genuinely have no idea what you're referring to.
How come Americans have the right to kill anyone they want with a gun?
Well, they don't. Murder is illegal in the United States, but they do have the right to own weapons.
They have the right to bear arms?
Correct.
But bears don't have arms.
They do, actually.
Oh, do they?
Yes.
I thought they were legs.
Well, I'm not a biologist, but I suppose that when they stand up, they're probably arms.
John F. Kennedy won the Cuban Missile Crisis. Why did he shoot himself afterwards?
Well, he didn't. He negotiated a settlement to the Cuban Missile Crisis with the Soviet leader, Nikita Khrushchev. And then after that, he ended up being assassinated in Dallas, Texas in 1963, unfortunately. But he didn't fire the bullet.
Right. It's ironic that he was so concerned about Cuban missiles when it was a gun in Texas he should have been worried about. I bet he was kicking himself after he was shot. Abraham Lincoln was shot in the theatre box, wasn't he? Where is that on the body?
Oh, I think you're referring to the physical location he was in when he was shot, which was in the presidential box at Ford's Theater in Washington, D.C.
And why was he shot? Was it because he wouldn't take his hat off? Because that's quite annoying in the theatre, isn't it, when someone's in front of you with a hat on?
Well, he was in the presidential box, so there wasn't anyone behind him, as far as I know. But he was shot by a man named John Wilkes Booth, who was a believer in the Confederacy.
How did being shot in the head affect Lincoln's ability to lead?
Well, it ended it, because he died about 12 hours after he was shot.
So he couldn't carry on?
He couldn't, no. Not as a corpse, unfortunately.